Remember, Carrot, you've cornered my bishop, but I don't think you expected this.
Hey, guys.
Josh, what are you doing?
I'm playing chess with my new buddy, the giant carrot. Giant carrot? But what about the big ear of corn?
What about him? He's a lousy chess player.
Could you keep your voice down? He might hear you.
I don't care.
The giant carrot and I are friends, and if the
big ear of corn can't handle it, then that's his problem.
You know, it'd be one thing if you were here with a fruit or a member of the nut family, but to be in here with another giant vegetable right in front of the corn is just cruel.
There's something weird about this giant carrot.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Something's just not right about it.
What are you guys talking about?
Josh, I hate to break it to you, but this giant carrot is a fake.
That's impossible!
Whose move is it, Josh, buddy?
Kevin.
Hi, guys.
Kevin, what are you doing in there?
It's just that, you know, I know how y'all like the big ear of corn and all, and, well, I thought if maybe I was a giant vegetable, you'd like me too.
You tricked me! I feel so tricked!
Actually, I kind of like Kevin better as a giant carrot.
Me too. Yeah, me too.
My bad.
Hey, guys, guess what finally came in today's mail? Those 25 bunnies I ordered.
Uh-oh.
Hey,
fresh out the box. Stop. Look and watch. Ready yet? Get set. It's all that.
To make sure that your children get a decent meal wherever you may be.
But we packed sandwiches.
Well, it's a good thing I took a look at those sandwiches. There were no peas on them at all.
But it's supposed to be. We don't want to eat peas.
Well, honey, I shouldn't really mean that. I'll just give you some for later. Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
Thanks.
About a little pea-loving angel.
Oh, hey, guys. Look. Look at the size of this batch. We can cook it for dinner.
Oh, no, baby. You don't want that. Give me a bag. Oh. Let me show you what you should be fishing for.
Peas? Yuck. I hate peas.
Sorry. You said that you hate peas, and I know that you wouldn't rather eat that slimy, scaly, nasty, worm-eating water lizard than some delicious peas, would you?
Yes, I would.
Twice. How you like it now? Careful, Miss Billy. You almost let your evil dark side take over.
Come on, I got the campfire going. Let's make s'mores.
Oh, good idea. But never mind about the marshmallow, baby. Miss Pillin is going to show you how to make real s'mores. First, you get some peas on your stick, like this here. And then you get them roasted to a nice golden brown. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then you stick them on a piece of graham cracker with some chocolate. Just like this. Needs a little bit more pieces. There you go.
Oh, ew! Who's gonna eat that?
You are.
No way, that's gross.
Gross? I see. Well, you know, Miss Penny went to all the trouble to make a piece smaller, and Her Majesty declares it gross.
You're smoking again. Please don't freak out.
You know, Miss Penny, suddenly I don't feel like eating.
Yeah, I'm pretty full. Maybe we should tell ghost stories.
Yeah, ghost stories. Good idea. I got one. It was a dark and stormy night when some children went to the cafeteria. But when they got there were no bees. I said, there were no bees.
I'm so scared about that. Who cares if there's no bees? Oops.
Oh, well, you know what? I'm gonna pretend that I didn't hear that. No, second thought, I did hear that. Yep, Miss Billy. People are gonna think you're not healthy in the head.
Guys, let's just go to sleep. We have a big hike to go on tomorrow. Far away from here.
Get up. Stay with her. And luckily, Miss Dillon brought her special sleeping bag.
Ah,
yay. Miss Dillon is going to rest in peace.
What was that?
Sounds like a grizzly bear. Well, honey, don't worry. He's probably just hungry for me. I'll get him some. Get up. Uh-oh. We out. Julio! Julio, you remember the children.
Here you go, Miss Piddlin, more peace. Hey, good luck with that bear.
Here you go, Mr. Bear. You want some peas? You don't want peas?
Careful, Miss Piddlin. That bear is dangerous.
You know who's dangerous? Miss Piddlin is dangerous. When she finds out that this overgrown rat who eats trash won't eat none of her pee. Oh, yeah. Excuse me, Tim. I got to handle some things. Oh, yeah. Get it. Oh, thank you. It was nothing, children. It was nothing. Why don't we all just calm down and sing a little happy campfire song? Julio! Peace in the world. Peace for the children. These are the ones that make a dinner great. So let's start to eat again.
And now, Danny Tamborelli with vital information for your everyday life.
If you're talking to your date, it would be rude to say, you know, I had liver for dinner last night, and it reminded me of you because it made me sick. When in Rome, do as the Romans do. When in France, do this. Every dog will have his day, but he'll probably just waste it chewing on bones and pooping in the garden.
This is the
out here. As usual, I have absolutely
absolutely no idea why you sent me here.
Oh, you seem to be getting a great tan.
Tan, Brenda? I have a blistering third-degree sunburn. It hurts to blink.
Brian, too much. So tell us, what's the weather like in the rest of the world?
Let's take a look at the map. Shall we? As you can see, the rest of the world is all nice and cool.
So what is that big red spot with the skull and the crossbones? What's that mean?
That little red spot means it's the hottest place on planet Earth.
Congratulations!
Oh, it's so hot out here, this bat is catching fire!
You know what's funny, Rick? See, here in the studio, we've got the air conditioner going, and it's actually a little chilly in here. But you're not bad. Under the sun, I'm jealous.
Trust me, Brenda. This much sun is no fun. Let me show you how hot it is out here.
Air-conditioned studio. I'm Brenda Stone.
Very hot.